What?
Thump. The girl holds her body into mine, pushing me aside to run off to a corner of the park. What's her problem? Phew. She's trying to threaten me from all the way over there. It seems strange yet familiar. It's okay, Fu-chan. Your big sister knows him. After a moment, she begins to inch toward me with apprehension. And I'll say hello. This is my little sister, Fuko. And this is Okazaki-san, the husband of a girl I taught. Nice to meet you. Yeah, nice to meet you. This is Ushio. Introduce Ushio, still cradled in Ibuki-sensei's arms. Huh? She's cute. Fuko wants to hold her too. Are you sure you'll be okay? It's okay. Is that alright, Okazaki-san? Sure. Ibuki-sensei puts Ushio down and in her place, the girl named Fuko picks her up. They're nearly the same height, so it just looks like they're hugging one another. Everyone laughs when they see this. That's very rude of all of you. Fuko is mad. Fuko's taking this girl home with her. Fu-chan, don't be so silly. Is Fuko not allowed to slip into the crowd? No. Your arm must be getting tired, right? Why don't you put her down? Fine. She puts Ushio down, who stands there with nowhere to go. When I call her over, she runs toward me and grabs onto my leg. She was in the hospital for a very long time. Oh, really? Yes, she was asleep for a while, and she was in the middle of rehabilitation right now. Finally, I was allowed to start going outside last month. She's supposed to try to move around as much as she can right now, so the three of us go out like the sun our days off. But going to a park practically makes Fuko look like a little kid. Fuko actually likes doing adult things for fun, like playing billiards. Do you want to go on the swing, Fu-chan? Oh, Fuko will do it for you. Seems overjoyed to do it. Fuko-chan was asleep for a very long time. Sane-san begins to talk to me as we watch the three have fun. I suddenly remember a story that Nagisa once told me. Very long time, for years. Had been asleep the whole time. Koko-san waited because she said she couldn't just live her life knowing that Fuko-chan was in a coma. So Yoshino-san waited with her. The two kept waiting. For years. I'm sure they had to go through a lot. I'm sure there were even times when they nearly gave up. But they were able to make it through, and now they're here. It's amazing, really. They're so strong. Yes, they're very strong. I feel embarrassed. So, let's congratulate them. We'll do it from here, in a loud voice. What, from here? Yes, but there are a lot of other people around. I realize as soon as I say the words. I should have stopped caring about that kind of thing a long time ago, ever since I started living with this family. Okay, let's do it. Congratulations on leaving the hospital and getting married. Yeah. Okay, now say it out loud. 1, 2, 3. Congratulations on leaving the hospital and getting married. Voices ring through the air. Everyone in the park, even people we don't know, turn around, and then they loudly begin to applaud. Thank you very much. Thanks. Fuko doesn't understand, but thank you. What a kind town this is. After that, once we visit Nagisa's parents to say hello, on our days off, we spend time playing in the park. It's one of Ushio's favorite places to go. It's no surprise since it's right in front of a home she lived in for so long. Must have a strong spot in her memory as a place where she spends time playing with Sane-san and the old man. Look around and see lots of parents with children, just like me. Most are mothers. And greet them again and again, just like when I drop off and pick up Ushio from kindergarten. Of course, I don't have much to talk about with the housewives, so I'm not able to be a part of their gossip circles. After making the rounds saying hello, I put Ushio on a swing and give her a push from behind. Ushio's eyes move away from me, gonna look at a group of children playing together. Do you want to play with them? No, it's okay. want to be with you right now, Daddy. I played with him a lot. Oh, your show is trying to get back to the last time as well. Dango, Dango. Your shoe begins swinging as she swings back and forth. I join in. I can only hope that this part comes to a hold a place in both our memories. The first Sunday of October, Ibuki-sensei and Yoshino-san have their wedding ceremony. It takes place at school. The modest ceremony is held in a single-plane classroom among a small gathering of close friends and relatives. Both Yoshino and I are present. Two exchange an eternal oath right at this place where Ibuki-sensei used to teach. Ibuki-sensei is so beautiful, and Yoshino-san too. I cannot help feeling jealous of his appearance. They truly fit each other so well. I can't thank you enough for being here today, everyone. Koku-san bows down before us. She walks out together with Yoshino-san, a bouquet in hand. We applaud and cheer as we see them out. Another happy scene I've had the opportunity to experience. Tomorrow's a health and support and sports day. Both Ushio and I have the day off. What do you want to do tomorrow, Ushio? I want to play. Well, of course we're going to play. The question is what it is you want to do. You want to go to the park again? Look at those pajamas. Dango. It's holiday. After all, it'd be nice to do something special. Just then the phone rings. Oh, the phone. 1 second. Okay. Yeah, this is Okazaki. Hello, Tomoe-san. It's Sanae-san's voice. This is Sanae. Good evening. Good evening. Sorry to have to ask on such short notice, but do you have any plans tomorrow? No, I was just talking to Ushio about what we were going to do. She coming up with yet another plan. If that's the case, what perfect timing. In that case, I have a favor to ask. Yeah, what is it? This is Sanae-san talking to me. After all, I'm sure she's going to suggest something amazing. Do you remember how Ibuki-sensei had her little sister with her? Little sister? Fuko-chan. Oh, I do remember something around her feet. Yes, Fuko-chan says she wants to come to your house to play, Tomoe-san. Excuse me? Her older sister, Koko-san, asked me if I could ask you. Would you play with her tomorrow? Yes? Why me? I think it's because Fuko-chan took a liking to Ushio-chan. Don't have anything to do with it. It seems like a good opportunity for her to go out on her own, too. You know how Fuko-chan was in the hospital all the time, and Koko-san never let her side, left her side. Since she had her own, she said on her own that she wanted to play with Ushio-chan. Koko-san wants to make that happen. Also, seems like Fuko-chan is very shy around strangers, which makes it really unusual for her to want to play with at a home of someone who she just met. Seems to be very interested in you too. Finding that hard to believe. Can you please help us out, Tomoe-san? For a moment, I don't know how to reply, but I can't turn down a request by Sanae-san. Sure, that's fine. Really? I'm glad to hear that. I knew that you were a kind person, Tomoe-san. I'll give Fuko-chan your address, and I think she'll be by in this afternoon. Alright. Is it okay if I give Koko-chan your home phone number? She said she wanted to thank you. She said yes. Yeah, I don't mind. I'll let her know. Thank you. Please do. Okay, have a nice holiday. I hang up. I wonder how nice the holiday will really be. My impression of this Fuko girl isn't the best to begin with. Yep, I mean, she did try to kidnap Ushio. Hey, Ushio. Yeah? We're gonna have a visitor tomorrow. Huh? You met her before, the girl who hugged you in the park, you remember? I remember. She said she's coming here to meet you. Okay. Does that make you happy? Yeah. Really? Mm-hmm. Well, if that's how you feel, it's fine with me. She does seem really interested in you, so just don't let her kidnap you. Okay. After that, Ibuki-sensei calls and we speak on the phone. She thanks me so many times that I start to feel like I should start thanking her back. The following day, Fuku comes by while I'm making lunch earlier than expected. Hello. And hello to you. Fuku is here to play. Please. She greets me in an unexpectedly polite manner. May Fuku come in? Nice to hear this song again. Yeah, but I'm right in the middle of making lunch. Come in and sit down. Okay, pardon, Fuku. It's really cramped in here. So all that politeness was just the script that Ibuki-sensei taught her. I'm convinced that of that as her demeanor drastically changes the moment she steps in the room. Oh, found you, Ushio-chan. She runs and slides into Ushio, then picks her up. Hey, be careful. Ushio-chan, do you want to become my little sister? That's not gonna happen. Fuku's asking Ushio-chan. Ushio-chan, why don't you become Fuku's little sister? She faces Ushio and asks her again. I'm always gonna be with Daddy. Hear that? Is that so? And Fuku will win you over by the end of the day. You're here to play, right? No, it's just an excuse. Fuku's only here to take back Ushio-chan. What exactly was she yours to begin with? So, Ushio-chan, Fuku bought lunch, and let's eat together. I'm right in the middle of making lunch, you know. Eat it yourself. Ushio-chan will eat with Fuku. Maybe I should chase her out of the apartment, but Ibuki-sensei did thank me all those times. I'll force myself to put up with it for now. Here, bread. Wait, from Furukawa bread? Yeah, bread from Furukawa bread. This is specially made. It's the only bread like it in the world. Brings out a star-shaped bread, a piece of bread from her bag. I think it's more like a starfish. That's cuter than I expected, knowing your personality. Will you eat it? Will you eat it for Fuku? Yeah. Ushio nods. Here. Ushio takes the piece of starfish-shaped bread and begins to eat. Is it good? Yeah, it looks good. The old man make it, not Sanai. Ah, cute little Ushio-chan. He's eating a cute bread, a piece of cute bread, cuteness squared. Fuku wants to eat it all up too. Please don't. It was tasty. Finishes the piece of bread. Okay, let's go home. She grabs Ushio's hand and stands up. Don't kidnap her right in front of her father. This isn't kidnapping, this is what she wants. Liar. Ushio-chan, you want to become Fuku's little sister, don't you? I want to be with Daddy. It's harder to win you over than Fuku originally thought. You two just met. Do you really think you're going to persuade her that easily? I go back to making the food I had to put on hold. I light the burner again and heat up my frying pan. Today's lunch is my specialty fried rice, which is quickly becoming a staple around the house. Add in a ton of pepper too. Fuku, do you also want some fried rice? My back is still turned to her as I ask. Are you trying to win Fuku over? Yeah, right. Fuku's big sister told her. Told you what? That your wife passed away. Yeah, she did. Fuku can understand if you end up seeing traces of her in Fuku. I make 3 plates of fried rice. One is an extra large, while the other two are on the small side. Just so you know, you and Nikki's are completely different. I line the plates up on the table and sit down, so much so that I think you might have come from a different planet. So your wife was like an alien? I'm talking about you. Fuku isn't an alien. Well, I can't understand what makes you tick. You're the alien, Okazaki-san. Fuku thinks an extremely average earthling-like way. And that's how the average earthling thought that's how the average earthlings thought this planet would be done for within 3 days. Fuku doesn't understand what you're talking about at all, Okazaki-san. Okay, then say there's a button in front of you that you shouldn't press under any circumstance. What do you do? Hide and press the button in secret. That button was to launch a nuclear missile, you know. I really am glad the average Earthling doesn't think like you. We actually would be done for in 3 days. No fair, that was a leading question. How exactly? Here's a question from Fuko. What is it? Say there's a pair of tights that you shouldn't wear under any circumstance. What would you do, Okazaki-san? I wouldn't do anything. That's a lie. You wouldn't be able to control yourself. Fuku knows you'd wear the tights, Okazaki-san. And then the nuclear bomb would begin to simultaneously explode all around the world. Those are some crazy tights. I'm glad the average Earthling doesn't think like you, Okazaki-san. The Earth would have been destroyed in a day. You're pretty funny, you know that? Ushio-chan, your father has fallen in love with Fuko. Just be quiet and eat. I hand Fuko a plate of fried rice. There isn't any sleeping powder in this, is there? You could be sound asleep and I still wouldn't even consider laying a finger on you. Don't worry. Does that mean you think of Fuko dearly? Not in the slightest. You'll have some too, won't you, Ushio? It's fine if you leave some, just eat. I hand Ushio another small-sized portion. Okay. Thank you for the food. After we give her thanks, we begin eating. It's tasty. Is it Fuko? Is it Fuko's happy to hear that? Don't say things like make it sound like you cooked this. But Fuko is sure that Ushio thinks in her heart that the bread from earlier was tastier. You know you didn't make the bread right either. Fuko was it? Was its producer. All he did was say what shape he wanted it in. Fuko is practicing how to cook. Don't say things that make it sound like Fuko can't cook at all. Okay, you're a great cook, so just eat the fried rice before it gets cold, please. It won't taste good if it gets cold. Okay, Fuko will eat it if you insist that much. She finally grabs her spoon and begins to eat. Fuko has lost. What is this? It's super crazy delicious. Everything Fuko does seems strange. It's enough to weird me out, but Ushio seems to enjoy it. She's been smiling this whole time. I enjoy being able to spend time alone with Ushio, but I realize that it might be a nice change for pace for her to spend time with other people as well. Okay, Ushio-chan, let's play. Behind me, the two begin to play as I clean up the dishes. Fuko brought a card game. This is a starter kit. Wow, Fuko had a really rare card in it. Look, Ushio-chan, its attack is so high. You'd be helpless if Fuko attacked you with it. Is that game actually fun for 5-year-olds? Excuse me? I'm asking if a 5-year-old can understand how that game is played. Oh, this game has a suggested age of 10 and up. I'm sorry, Ushio-chan, it looks like you're not ready for this yet. I doubt she'll be interested even after she turns 10. In that case, let's play cards. Why didn't you just bring those out at first? What card games can you play, Ushio-chan? Can you play blackjack? Hold on, of course you can't. Is it too hard? I'm sorry, Fuko is very grown up, so Fuko ends up suggesting nothing but adult games. How about sevens? That game is too much fun, it's devilish. You're such a child. Yeah, I want to play sevens. Okay, then let's do it. Just wait, I'll play you once I'm done cleaning up. Okay. What a hopeless man. Get to work. I hope you know I'm cleaning the dishes that you ate off of. Fuko doesn't have cards to play now because of you, Okazaki-san. Ushio-chan, your father is very rude to girls. You should get a new one. No, daddy is kind. Fuko finds that hard to believe. Oh, you got Fuko again. Hear the sound of cards being played mixed with their laughing voices. Makes me think, if only Nagisa were still here, the three of us would have been playing cards just like this. This would have been what our average holidays were like. Okazaki-san. Yeah, must have been spacing out. Just as Fuko thought. You see your wife and Fuko, don't you? Fine. I'll make a huge concession and admit that you two share the same sex, okay? What a personality different Was she childish, unlike Foucault? I don't know a single person more childish than you. But well, yeah, she could seem like a child. When I say this, Foucault suddenly begins fixing her hair. Why are you acting embarrassed by me saying that? Did you wish you would never know her mother? Nope. Daddy told me a lot of things, so I know a lot about her. Is that so? What kind of person was your mother, Ushio-chan? A big crybaby. But someone who worked really hard to give birth to Ushio-chan. Ushio, not... She didn't call herself Chan. And someone who really loved Daddy. The numbers on the cards are hard to make out. I wonder why. Can't keep playing. Foucault. Doesn't have any plans for a while. You can invite Foucault over any time. What? Foucault said that she'll come whenever you ask her to. Are you actually trying to be considerate? No, Foucault just said that she wants to come over, so please invite her. That's right, Foucault just wants to play with Ushio-chan. Oh, okay then. Could it be that someone told her about what I've gone through? My awful lifestyle after I left Nagisa. Sanai-san did say that she was friends with the girl's older sister. Maybe I'm overthinking it. Foucault. Yes? We're okay now. Foucault doesn't understand what you're saying. No. I knew that you're more like an alien than Foucault, Okazaki-san. Is that so? Well, Foucault's going to have to leave you now. Just say you're going home, like a normal person. Okay, Foucault's going home. See you, come back again. Okay, now let's go, Ushio-chan. Don't try acting all natural while dragging her off with you. But Foucault just has to take her home. You really shouldn't make impossible requests to a kid's parents like that. Well, fine then. But there will be plenty more opportunities in the future. Please be sure to watch your neck at night. And you're expecting me to invite you over again. Sorry, pretend you didn't hear that. Foucault's a very good girl. Foucault doesn't cause any problems, just like a hibernating bear. You're gonna wake up one day. With that said, goodbye, Ushio-chan. Okay, goodbye. Foucault will say hello to you even if we meet outside of this home. Okay. Foucault even remembers what you smell like now, so Foucault will know if you're nearby. He really is just like a bear. And when we are, let's play together. Okay. Pat Ushio's head and then... Alright then. Finally leaves. I'm exhausted. She's a funny person. I'll admit she's fun to be around, but can't she do something about her habit of saying everything that comes to mind with absolutely no social filter? Hello, I'm here to pick my daughter up. Hey, nice work. He raises her hand to greet me and walks toward me. Where's Ushio? She's playing with Botan. She enjoys using his back as a slide. He's okay with that? He seems to like it too, since it stimulates his back. I see. Ki walks back inside the kindergarten and calls for Ushio. Ushio-chan, good for nothing, he's here to pick you up. Bastard, that's how you refer to a parent in front of her kid. But it's true, isn't it? I'm trying my best now. If you keep at it, I'll stop calling you that. I sure hope that's the case. Ushio comes running toward me and holds onto my leg. Seeing my daughter's cute behavior, I can't help but break into a smile. Welcome back. Yeah, I'm back. And okay? It's okay, isn't it? Okay then, I'm back. Have you been good? Yep. Has this person been bullying you? Who are you pointing at? Ushio shakes her head sideways. She's really gentle. What's with that expression? Is there something you aren't happy with? No, it's just once I start thinking about what happened back in high school. Well, I can't say the same with you. To you with how much of a mature father you look now. Do I really? You really look like a doting parent, the way you cracked a smile. Having heard her say that, my hand immediately reaches for my face. Ushio-chan, isn't it a pain that daddy's so sloppy? Yoshio shakes her tiny head sideways. Daddy's really cool. Oh? I guess she has an eye for guys. It's scary what happens when you get used to something. Q lets out a sigh. Oh yeah, we handed out a printout today. Oh, is that so? Look at Yoshio, who nods in response. It's a notice for a field day. There'll be events that parents participate in too, so be sure to prepare yourself for that. There'll be an orientation for parents next week. I don't know if I can go to that one, I'll probably have to work. Be sure to come to the real thing. Yoshio grabs and pulls on my pants. What's up? I want to see. See what? How awesome Daddy is. Yeah, sure thing, I'll show you. I may not look it, but I run pretty fast. At least back in high school. Was that so? Q turns away under my glare. Anyway, since I do physical work every day, I don't think I've lost any strength. Besides, I'm quite young for a parent, no? I bet I won't lose to those middle-aged parents. I wonder about that. What's that supposed to mean? Never mind, well, don't embarrass yourself in front of Yoshio-chan. I'll be fine. I look forward to it. Yeah, I look forward to it. Other than that, I think I would like Sane-san and the old man to come. I want them to see how hard you work. Yep. Oh yeah, I guess now's a good time to get a new camera. I'll take a lot of photos of you. Yep. Field day, huh? I think you can take a lot of nice photos. I imagine how she would look. Maybe she looks really cute when she's trying, so it can't be helped. If I send those photos to TV networks, I bet she'll be accepted right away. Then talent agencies will all be trying to rope her in. That's gonna give me some mixed feelings as a parent, though. Yoshio, start practicing your autograph while you can. Be sure to give me your very first one. What a doting parent. Eh? It's only natural, right? An idiotic one, too. The next day happens to be Sunday, so when I go to the Furukawa's with Yoshio on my day off, make sure to also talk about the field day. Sup? Yoshio and I walk into the Furukawa Bread. Hello, Tomoe-san. Hello to you, Yoshio. Hello. It's past noon, so the old man is already gone. Have you already eaten lunch? Yeah, we had my special fried rice. It was tasty. She's able to eat pepper now. Really? What a good girl. Her next challenge is to take on half peppers. Isn't that right? Challenge. You seem excited to do it. But I think you need to wait a bit longer on that one. Thought you might say that. I've been getting a lot better at cooking thanks to her being around. She'll just come out and say it when I cook something that doesn't taste good. Sane-san's food tastes better. See? You'll just have to keep getting better then. Three of us drink glasses of fruit juice that Sane-san prepared for us. So I brought this with me today. I unfold the piece of paper I'm holding out and hand it to Sane-san. Oh, field day. Will you come and support Yoshio? Yes, of course I'll be coming. Sounds like you already knew about it. Yeah, I did. Actually, we were contacted about it as well. Huh? We heard about it when we spoke to the head of the kindergarten at the neighborhood association. Huh? He invited us to participate. Participate, you mean, instead of just watching? Yeah, as members of the parents' team. Sounds great. I'm in the same situation. Let's be on the team together. Wouldn't I be a bother? Of course not. It'd be great if you could be there, Sane-san. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Then I'll go with Akio-san. What? Oh no. The old man will be there too. I totally forgot about him. It looks like he's home. Hey, I'm back from my road work. The old man is behind me. He's shadow boxing. Makes you want to put these skills to use. What exactly are you planning to enter? The big fall field day, of course. It'll be a one-round knockout. There's no boxing event on field day. Shut up, I'm cutting weight right now. Again, there's no need to do something like that. Yeah, there is. You think you can run around with my belly hanging out? What about you? You want to go in without any preparation? Talk about lazy. No father would go this far after Yield Day. Ha, have fun showing your bruised and battered face to Route 2, Shio. Ken, there's no competition like that at Field Day. Akio's son is a fast runner, so he was asked to be the anchor for the relay. As a part of the teacher's team, because the head of... as part of the teacher's team, because the head of the kindergarten has a hurt back. He's not a teacher. Shut up, that's just how popular I am. No complaints. So, get to fix whatever mess these stupid teachers make. I think I like the situation I've been put in. Popular. Yeah, I'm sure teachers just love people who call them stupid. So I tell the head of the kindergarten to make this guy the anchor of the parents' team. It'll be a faded showdown. Now that would really get me fired up. No, forget about getting fired out. You just got a bit of... You just got a big hit off of the other day in front of Ushio. I'll make sure you look like such a disgrace in front of everyone that you won't even be able to show your face around town. Do your best so that doesn't happen. Sane-san seems to be serious about this too. Seriously trying to get me to face off against him. Who do you think is going to win, Ushio? Sane-san asks Ushio as she sits there on her own, sipping her juice. Takes her mouth off her straw. Haki. Him again? Listen, she learned how to steal bases by watching me at work. What kind of person actually gives it their all when stealing bases against children? But I want Daddy to win. I see, so your dreams won't match up with reality. You're pretty smart for a kid, you know that? You shouldn't be so concerned with the cold, hard truth at your age, Ushio. Chase after your dreams. And wait a second, what's going on here?